Good morning. I have to talk a little bit about my plans, my intentions with the wine cooperatives here in France. Now, as the system is currently, they have this group over here, and it's just is a bunch of farmers, and they pour all of their wines together, and it creates one variety. And that particular variety is sold. And it's just many farms joined together. And that is working, sort of, but it's not always the greatest wine. It's just more of a table wine. It's not something that's fantastic. Now, I really think after what's gone on with Australia, after what's gone on with even the Napa Valley, California, we have to revert back to making only the beautiful special wines. And when I'm talking the beautiful special wines, I'm even talking shade grapes. There are grapes here that grow in the shade. Now, grapes in the shade are not as plentiful, do not grow as many. However, they do have a taste. They do have a taste darker. And it is something that I have not had, normal, unless they're out there adding smokes and all of these other things into the wine. So, for some reason, there is a natural state that it already has. The grape itself already has this natural state, and that natural state comes from the shade. Now, when they went through and they took Béziers and they took down to Perpignan and they went all the way through the Narbonne and they just went and just shredded it into just nothing but openness and just grape after grape after grape after grape, vine. No, it's nothing special. It's just nothing special wine. And then they go and they add, of course, they're adding the sulfites also for shelf life or longevity or something with it. More and more have become the bio-organic, which is better. They call it bio-organic here. smelly, smelly organic, the bio. But yeah, B-E-O. And So what I'm definitely trying to say is more of a different type of a wine group. I want the wines more specialized than what they have been. That's basically it's all I'm saying about that. The wine monarchy itself, we have that duty to bring back different varieties, and even the shade grape as a tremendous one. So, I'm also talking older grapes from very rare grapes from years and years before. Many more dark heavies. Not any of these light watered wish downs. I'm not even happy with selling the grapes off the first year. I believe selling the grapes off the first year has become a disaster for France also. Because there it is, the person is just like, you know, they're going to drink it, they're going to get in it. It just gave me a bellyache, a headache the next day. It was awful. Why are we giving people poison, you know, to their bodies? Wait until it is something that is certain. That is going to be helpful to their palate, to their health. Don't give them something that is just wretched. So I'm even holding back the wine longer until it tastes good and is palatable. So we really need to stop it with all this stupid gold here, metal. I've tasted your gold medals, I've tasted your silvers, I've tasted your bronze. They're not so spectacular. I'm not pleased with any of the young wines. They're way too young. So we need to stop that process and not allow them on the market until they've aged further. Yeah, because that's bad advertising for France, isn't it? It's bad advertising forever. I went there and got some really cruddy wine. I had a bad trip. People were rude to me. They just were like, oh, snotty French, the snotty French rude to me. Yeah, I don't know. We still have tourists, you know, we still have tourists. So yeah, that's the wine portion of where I'm going. Back to the casino. I know I was getting pretty heavy for a mirage look there, but yet I'm now, I don't know, maybe it's just because the fishnet tights are fun. But no, I have to think also, maybe something a little more Santa Barbara. A little more Santa Barbara. Maybe not so many stories. Maybe only two or three stories of, well, I don't know. See how easy it is to say four or five. I don't know. There is something to it, isn't it? When it gets Disney versus, and then they're going to say, well, we have to have a place for the children, and so then we have to have the circus one, and then Vegas starts to be built, and I'm like, oh, I don't know if I want an entire Vegas strip there. Maybe we'll just do little by little, just start with a little Santa Barbara style, and maybe they have to dress up a little bit, dress up to go into the casino. Maybe not just, they have to show up with something, jackets or something, still have some kind of decorum rather than just the dredges that I just have to drop nickels in for a hope, don't want any of that going on. Nothing Battle Mountain-y. I have to have the nickels before breakfast dropped into the machine. Yeah, we don't want that enveloping. That doesn't really charm anything. You see, there's a time endurance also. When you get dressed before you go to the casino, there's a time endurance that gives you a patience moment, doesn't it? You're a patient in that moment. You're like stopping your frustrations of the have to. You have to get ready. You have to get ready. You have to get prepared. And when you're getting ready and you're getting prepared and you're getting your shoes prettied up and your clothes prettied up, it just says something about your day. And so maybe you're going to make more sensible decisions with your money and with your gambling. And maybe you enjoy it more. Maybe you enjoy the whole experience more, even if you lose that day. But if you go in there with your little tennis shoe Nike on, I'm sorry, Nike, I don't mean to hit you hard, but if you go in there with your tennis shoe Nike on and some old shorts, and you have, I don't know, a few holes in your pockets and maybe a few chains just falling through those holes, and I don't know, dribbles on your t-shirt. If you're this type of person, you're just waiting there. What is it, 8 o'clock? Is it open already? Isn't it a 24-hour casino? If you start getting this way, that doesn't help. It doesn't help anything. We don't really want that particular momentum down there in the south of France ever. So I'm really gonna have to say it's gonna be a dress. Hey, we have to dress up for it just a little bit. And that will be some kind of jacket for the men, and women I would prefer obviously in their dresses. I would prefer women in dresses. Gosh dang it, women are so much more beautiful in dresses. Come on, I'm so sick of pants and pantsuits and lesbianic looking women everywhere. Put your dresses back on. Just put your dresses back on. Men respected you much more then. There were less murders to women when you had your dresses on. Just put your dresses back on. So enough said, enough said. So we played the dress-up party there instead of kino, 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 kino. I have to have kino. As I'm eating my omelet, we're not gonna go that way. But yeah, we can have the buffets. We can have the buffets, and so you can still have that fun luxury moment of all you can eat. Ha, it's Americans feeling. But yeah, we can still have that. But yet, I'm absolutely into organic foods, and so that is going to be the biggest push also from my kingdom here. Yeah, gosh dang it! So far, I've got triple, like a triple freaking bevy crown. The fountains of the berries and the vows. You cannot believe it. I have not. Why didn't somebody tell me this better when I was born? The day I was born. Oh, by the way, you are the Queen of France already. Why didn't somebody tell me this? Why didn't somebody just tell me? Why do I have to find this out by myself? of missed time, you know, a lot of missed time. A lot of stupidity. French going off to a war called Iran. Now they want to go to Iran? No, they never go to Iran. They go to Iraq. I think it's so dangerous for Iran that they even need to change their name to something else, like Novajna or something. Change their name to Novajna just so the Americans don't get it into their giddy little heads that they have to go after everything with an I. Everything that starts with an I. My gosh, Iran, change your name to Avinia or something. Oh no, that would be nice. Navinia. That would be a fun one, huh? Navinia. Goes back to Nvidia. There was a town, an original town, long, long time ago, before Babylon. But yeah, that would be a good one. Nvidia or something. Well, then somebody says, that's a TV screen, Teresa. It's a TV screen. You don't want that. Well, call me Therese if you need to. If you're French, you can't say the tsa at the end. Go ahead and say Therese. And this is something else. You know, we have to think of, you know, the Americans, they have to remember certain tones are difficult to speak. And so we can't always be, like, expecting and demandant, you know. I know my name is Teresa, but you go with Therese. Therese, you know, that's easier. Easier, you know. So whatever. So what else is I going to say? I back to the casino. So I'm going with a little bit more classy what do we want? A little more downscale than Monte Carlo, though. Downscale than Monte Carlo. And there was something else. Gosh, I know I'm playing with my ridiculous incense here. There was something else. Palms, more palms. And yeah, that area grows palms, lots of desert palms. And so we can actually grow dates there. I believe we can grow dates. So it can become a date mecca zone also. So let's keep that in mind. It does get quite hot. And also, however, the winters, you still do need a coat. You still do need a coat. It can get, you know, into the 40s pretty easily. But it is possible to grow dates. So, my gosh, good thing for the women, huh? Good thing for the women. They can grow dates there also. So what was I next saying? gifts to the kingdom. Because there are so many castles under my tutelage, there are so many castles with the Vaux name, with the Fontaine name, the Fontenay names, the berries, the Roquettes of who I am. I'm all of these castles again and again and again and again. And so I'm like, well, and then there's Vaucluse, and then there. So we have to start thinking. We have to start thinking about keeping these castles in the best shape possible, and keeping them also accepting gifts. We want gifts for the new kingdom. So this is a moment that we are looking for people around the world who are running their particular regions to be gladiating our moments, and to give gifts. And the gifts I'm looking for are the trees specific from their areas of the world. Very special trees, and we'll plant those as a friendship gift. So, my goodness. Yeah, there's quite a lot of businesses that must occur at the castles. We need more businesses to occur at the castles to bring in the profits. A lot of them do these little shows in the summertime, and the summertime shows are okay, and they bring in a few people, and maybe it's, you know, but it's really for a big hype of 2 weeks. It needs to be more than the hype of 2 weeks, doesn't it? It has to be much more than the hype of 2 weeks. I need longevity tourism all year round. Not just for the 2 weeks. I know everyone shuts down because of the snow of Paris in the winter, but we have to stop that. We have to bring people in, even in the cold, even in the snow. That's an idea for that one, the Vicomte one, is to have some fun cross-country cross-country skiing is very much possible to have cross-country going on there. Something fun, something even dog sled racing. We can have fun there because it is quite, I don't know, it's just like a massive horrible, and if you see it, it's actually a massive horrible an horrible exposure, and it's missing quite a lot. But yeah, we could have fun there. We could have let's bring in the Iditarod dog races. We will have a rejuvenation of go to Paris in the winter and you can race the dogs. There you go. So I have fun aside from just horseback riding in the snow. So yeah, we'll play that one. So I think that's all for this video.